Well, we have details of these. Make sure you also log on through our socials as you go search for TV3 Ghana, as well as 3news.com as we stream. And also watch us live through the DSTV channel 279.
All right, let's get into our stories for this evening. We begin with the Foreign Affairs Ministry as they have put in measures, and of course, to mention that analysts in the oil and gas sectors have charged government to, as a matter of urgency, present a turnaround plan for the Tema oil refinery. According to them, a reduction in taxes on fuel and a functioning refinery would provide some cushioning for Ghanaians against the hike in crude oil on the world market.
Prices of petroleum products went up sharply at the pumps in the first pricing window of February, and as expected, the ripple effect has been felt to many parts of the economy.
Now, this is how much you're buying a liter of petrol at 7 cedis 99 pesos. This is the upper limit of 7 cedis 99 pesos. It's between 7 cedis 30 pesos and 7 cedis 99 pesos, depending on the oil marketing company that's selling or where you're buying your fuel.
According to the National Petroleum Authority NPA price buildup published on this website, there are about 12 margins and levies on 1 liter of petrol or diesel that you buy. These are energy debt recovery levy 49 pesos, road fund levy 48 pesos, energy fund levy 1 peso, price stabilization and recovery levy 14 pesos, sanitation and pollution levy 10 pesos, energy sector recovery levy 20 pesos, special petroleum tax 46 pesos, primary distribution margin 11 pesos, boss margin 9 pesos, fuel market margin 5 pesos, marketers margin 46 pesos, dealers margin 30 pesos. If you add all 12 margins and levies imposed on the liter of petrol or diesel, you get a total of 4 cedis 25 pesos. What this means is that with the price of a liter of petrol or diesel at the pumps selling at 7 cedis 99 pesos maximum, out of that, 4 cedis 25 pesos are all taxes. That is over 50% of the price of a liter of petrol or diesel at the pumps, all made up of taxes and levies. With the current tensions between Russia and Ukraine, which has led to crude oil prices increasing over $100 per barrel, should government consider reducing some taxes? Executive Director of the Institute for Energy Security, Nana Moisi VII, believes government should.
$61.23 per barrel. Today, it's more than $100 per barrel. Let's say it's $100 per barrel. You see a clear windfall of close to $38 per barrel. And if price should stay around the same margin, then of course we are making a lot of money from our crude oil sales. That can compensate for any removal or suspension of taxes of levy and margins on a liter of fuel.
But chair of the oil and gas sector of the Association of Ghana Industries, Kwame Jantua, argues government may not cut down taxes.
When you look at the price build-up, there's nothing in the price build-up that government can change today. And the only way, nothing. The thing they could probably look at is the UPPF.
What difference would a functioning refinery have made in such turbulent times?
What are the plans to revive the fortunes of this refinery? Behind me here, the Tema Oil Refinery.
The Tema Oil Refinery, situated about 24 kilometers east of the capital, Accra, was originally named the Ghanaian-Italian Petroleum Company and incorporated as a private limited liability company under the company's ordinance, CAP 193, on December 12, 1960.
Unfortunately, TOR is in a coma and we don't know when it's coming back. If they were refining our indigenous crude, one advantage TOR will have gotten is the freight cost, because they will not be sourcing the crude oil from far. We have lost out on that. It will interest you to know that we say every economy, you've seen price on in every country going up. It is not true. Prices of fuel in Egypt from February last year to this year,
in April 1977, the government of Ghana bought all the shares of the Ghanaian Italian Petroleum and became the sole shareholder.